In the forecast fragment class, we add the callback interface that was provided in the gist. Then in the onCreateView method, we modify the listItemClick behavior. When an item is clicked, instead of always launching a new intent to the detail activity, we want to notify the callback instead. We call getActivity and then cast it to a callback object. Then we can call onItemSelected on it. We pass the URI that represents the selected location and date. Then in the main activity, we implement the callback interface. In the onItemSelected method, we fork the behavior based on the m2pane variable that we defined earlier. If we're in two-pane mode, then we create a detail fragment and put the URI inside the arguments bundle. Then we replace the existing detail fragment in the weather detail container using the detail fragment tag. In one-pane mode, we create a new intent to launch the detail activity and we set the data URI. In the detail activity, we modify the onCreate method to read the data URI from the incoming intent. We take the URI and set it as the arguments in the new detail fragment. Then we dynamically add this fragment to this container. In the detail fragment, we modify the onCreateView method to read the arguments that the fragment was initialized with. We read the data URI and store that in the member variable mURI. In the onCreateLoader method, we removed some code that relied on the incoming intent and switched it to use mURI instead. Whether this detail fragment is in the main activity or the detail activity, it should have mURI set. Then we're going to use mURI to query the content provider for the data to display in this detail fragment. When you try it out on the tablet, there is one bug related to navigation that we should fix. Say we select tomorrow's date. If you navigate to the settings activity and then hit the up button, the detail fragment is blank. That's because a brand new instance of main activity got launched. And for a brand new instance, nothing is selected yet. To fix this, when the Settings Activity Up button is pressed, we want to navigate to the previous running instance of the main activity, where the Tomorrow item is selected, and not create a new instance of main activity. In the Settings Activity, override this method, which the system will call in order to get the parent activity intent for the Up button behavior. Get the parent activity intent from the superclass. This should create a new intent to main activity. Then add the intent flag called FlagActivityClearTop. This flag indicates that we should check if the main activity is already running in our task and to use that one instead of creating a new main activity instance. Also, this method didn't exist prior to Jellybean, so we need to add this at target API annotation. If you check the documentation for the activity class, the getParentActivityIntent method was only added in API level 16, and you can check that version 16 maps to Jellybean.